You are, yeah. Minute we do the process of the active determine the short circuit important. What we to the same circuit as we did earlier. One the pro in that circuit into the wind. Both of these resistors, we have the whole not really, no. No real. There might be some cases where one would be easier to do than the other. Okay? But only experience any kind of chain. You can equivalent circuit back. Because remember, so going to fall as all through that 20 ohm resistor, 0 ohm. Then, isn't it, to calculate the current flowing this is Norton.
Yeah.
Norton. Oh yeah. And we're now back. In parallel, so if we put an ohm meter in here with a battery in it, current would flow down there, and down parallel. Over our one. Four ohms, isn't it? I don't mean Norton's at all. Now, is a Norton's equivalent circuit. One more, please. Current source. Current equals how many amps? We've got parallel RA. Equal to 4 ohms. We've got to put the 5 ohm resistor back in. And the 30 ohms. field. And what that. Calculate. Well, yeah, so effect. So we can. Drop across that pair of resistors one. you would get. As a clue, how we start on the board there, split it into two circuits A and B. Take out the individual sources, and then you're going to find I short circuit A and I short circuit B. And then one, hopefully one will be bigger than the other, and you'll find out the size and direction of the actual ISC. So you're going to use superposition again. What you got? What the final answer to ISC, or the answer to the current through the 8 ohm resistor, 0.074. So now you all know the final answer you're heading for, the current through the 8 ohm resistor is 0.074. Calculating those two individual currents and then subtracting the smallest one. One's current should be 2/3 of an amp. Okay, in the direction of ISCA. Meaning is not.